Kozlowski. Never saw it coming. A 3-on-2 now in the retake.
Oh, that is so smart, isn't it? Just giving, saying, no, I'm not going to fight for the bomb side, but I will take out that bomb planter now. 2 versus 3. Forrest with the AWP. Don't underestimate him either. He can be very, very quick with it. There's going to be a kill on Alex now, pushing in as Get Right goes down. Forrest with one more kill, and he's going to have one chance here. A missed shot will end him, but he's going to get the third one too. A fantastic triple kill out of Forrest here. And that's going to be NIP winning that round in spite of
this. He's going to be... That's got to be so frustrating if you're using the AWP that those don't connect in a little bit of a better fashion. Either way, he's put his team in a great position. Man advantage, Apex couldn't get involved, couldn't take the fights, and now they have a very quick flank. Everyone from NIP trapped inside this bomb site. The smoke is going to let Vitality get close up and be Halls for this retake. Three players now coming from Halls. That means Zywoo got to be patient with the AWP. There's the Molotov. Force gets aggressive, finds that, and now Get Right close up, but he doesn't realize it's all of them. He doesn't realize they all came from the tunnel, and Alex with 3 kills gets Vitality on 5, and it's a back-and-forth affair.
Yeah, that's actually a great scenario right there where you see how much the value of information is in a game like Counter-Strike, because I'm sure if Get Right had... If someone could have called it out quick enough or something...
Classic, but what makes it a classic, I think, is how often we see the run boost actually fail.
Oh, it's hilariously funny.
Yeah, it's so good, and actually, I think we should just force teams to try it.
Yeah.
Just so for the comedy purposes.
If nothing else, it does look funny. Oh, there's another 2-for-1 shot. Can he do it again? NBK at the back here. I mean, he's against pistols, but still, give him the ace. Oh,
oh, Apex is a dick.
Absolute bastard.
Oh, NBK had to have loved 2 players defending this B bomb site. If NIP get lured into attacking this side of the map, I think they'll be surprised at the amount of defense that Vitality is able to mount, especially because NBK looks on point with that AWP, but they're going to have to decide very quickly. Do you defend against the mid portion of this split, or do you defend against the B bomb site?
Oh, running right through MBK, still on point, he gets a follow-up kill as well! The third one! How is he doing it? Somehow, all 3 kills going for NBK. He had an AWP and they were... Again, might just be faking this out, and then... Who's gonna be throwing that mid to... that mid smoke to CT spawn? NBK gonna be jumping down instead and finding out that there's nobody here, so they don't even want that smoke now. 2 people defending mid here, out of the B bomb side. It's Plofsky coming up with a huge double kill. And Forrest and Electro, that double off, still doing work. And Plofsky's going to win that last fight to make it a triple. He's really making up for a bit of a slow start.
Yeah, he had 3 kills in the first half. He's up to 12 now. This is bad. Yeah.
All right. Electro up in the A bomb side with Rez over at long. So again, one of those kind of defenses here where if you lose either Lecro or Rez, the other player is going to be in trouble. Though a lot of damage to Alex early on. Get Right waiting down there. He's actually going to get the kill on Alex, and Lecro holding his own so far. And now things are looking fine here. They're up against the pistols. Oh, Get Right living through that. I don't know how.
Yeah, Vitality's bullets have stopped working. There's 3 ops on the CT side.
Wait, Rez killed Get Right with a grenade? And that was like after the fact, wasn't it?
Sacrifices must be made for the greater good.
Just no respect for the elderly in this.